15 News at 6.
I hear graffiti people saying it's artwork. Well, then do it in your mom's living room. Okay? We don't need it on the sides of our buildings.
Madison police eye a chronic problem. Now at 6, officers catch 3 suspects in a criminal act. Good evening, I'm John Stofflett. Lee is off. It has become a part of the Madison landscape, graffiti. But police rarely can catch suspects in the act. As NBC 15's Dana Bruick reports, some early morning surveillance paid off.
One of Madison's most popular streets also is one of the biggest targets for rooftop graffiti.
On State Street, with the access to fire escapes, they can be bigger without the chances of being caught being high.
But Lieutenant Dave McCaw says these 3 men rolled the dice and lost. With some fresh complaints about tagging, officers were conducting surveillance in the State Street area early this morning.
They set up on an area that had been recently tagged and heard the cans being shaken up, heard the spraying, could smell it.
Police say they caught the men in the act tagging this rooftop.
For many of them, it's a signature. It's the same type of paint or marker, the same font, the same colors.
2 patties.
Sean Powell works a few doors down at 5 Guys.
It's annoying, you know, we go through a lot of, you know, painstaking things to keep this very clean and very nice.
He says staff regularly deal with vandalism inside and out.
Outside in the back, we have our dumpsters, the walls in the back for where we park. We get stuff there all the time.
And what some call art costs local businesses time and money.
You have to sit out there for hours and scrub the concrete or the brick and trying to get the stuff off. And it doesn't always come off. You can still see it a little bit. Trying to remove it still makes it look trashy, and it doesn't help unless you completely repaint over everything.
But what's still visible could spell out more trouble for the men. Police say these tags on buildings along West Gilman Street resemble what they found on the roof.
If they hit 3 businesses and it's the same tag with the same artwork with the same name, we have 3 complaints.
It's a chronic problem, but police want people to know officers could be watching them too.
We are out there. You roll the dice and we'll see.
In Madison, Dana Bruick, NBC 15 News.
And those men face misdemeanor charges. Officers do not believe the tags were gang-related. A Middleton man is arrested.